Question. Is there an ultimate God? Does it exist? If so, what is it? Well, is there an ultimate God? I don't know. I don't know if there is. But what I do know is, as I've explained in my video about how the world was created, is that there are two levels of the world we live in. One is the level where you have these worlds of form, like we are in. We are in a specific world of form that was created by one being. I call it a creator. Most religions call it God. And there are many other worlds of form besides ours, created by other creators, innumerable of them. So this is the level where you have a world of form that created by one being, and it gradually evolves and transcends itself. And I've explained in my video about how the world was created. The purpose is that we can expand our consciousness so we reach the greater level of consciousness. Beyond this level, where you have these evolving worlds, you have something called the allness, where there are also beings, self-aware beings, but they are not evolving from one point towards a higher point. It doesn't mean they aren't growing, but it's just not the way we do it by having this world of form that's transcending itself. So I don't know very much about the allness. The Ascended Masters have not said a lot about it, other than there are these presences in the allness. And so I don't know if there's an ultimate God behind it all. My sense is that there isn't an ultimate God. And the reason why I say this is that you have the level of evolving worlds and you have the level of the allness, but the level of the evolving worlds came out of the allness, and the allness is, of course, experiencing all of these evolving worlds, and thereby the beings in the allness are transcending themselves because everything is constantly transcending itself. And where does it end? I mean, what could possibly be ultimate if there's constant self-transcendence? So I know that when I say this, the linear mind, the analytical mind, almost panics. I can even feel it in my own mind as I think about this, because what started it all? It must have started at some point. There must be some ultimate goal it's going towards. Why? Yes, our world of form had a starting point. That's what the linear mind can deal with. But the linear mind can't deal with something that doesn't have a starting point. There has always been a process of self-transcendence. It didn't start. It didn't start. Think about this and see how your mind panics. But you can come to intuitively sense this. Why did it have to start? That's just our programming by being in a world that did start. We project what we see in our world beyond our world, and that is the main problem with all kinds of religions. You look at the Old Testament God, the angry man in the sky. Who created that God? Angry men who ran around in physical embodiment and projected their own image and their own anger upon God. It says in Genesis, let us create man in our own image and after our own likeness. But as I explained, we can go into a state of separation where we lose connection to God, we lose connection to the spiritual realm. We see ourselves as separate beings, and when we go into separation, we create a God in our own image and likeness. Separation. And that's the Old Testament angry God in the sky. So the mistake we always make when we talk about God is taking what we see around us and our own psychology and projecting it upon God. And that's why I'm saying, I don't know if there is an ultimate God. what I can see is that everything is transcending itself. So how would there be something ultimate? And then I also know that we have an ego which is born out of separation and has these dualistic extremes, the dualistic way of thinking. And the ego always wants there to be something ultimate because it's always looking for security. So there has to be something ultimate, some ultimate knowledge. And that's why we are projecting this, there has to be an ultimate God. But again, why? I mean, in a sense, I would say, as I said from the beginning, I don't know, because I don't claim to understand God. I don't think that we, on a planet like Earth, that is an unnatural planet, that we can understand with our minds and grasp with our minds God. We can experience, I have experienced the presence of our Creator, but I cannot put any words or concepts on it because it would be a total betrayal of the experience, a degradation of the experience. So it's again this, a question like this. If the question is important for you, don't seek to answer it with a linear rational mind. Seek to have and do whatever you can do to have a mystical experience where you experience the presence of God. And that will get you to a point where you settle the question. Because for me, I wouldn't even ask this question. I would have 30 years ago. But today, it's just irrelevant to me. It just isn't important to me. I wouldn't even formulate the question today. And I'm not saying there's anything wrong with formulating the question. As I said, I had it myself. But I just see today that it was because I was in a certain state of mind, very attached to the linear mind, where you want to look at what's here and then you want to extend it. And since then I've had experiences that you can't reduce the presence of God to anything linear, any concept, any word, any idea. And that's why I'm saying, how can you, you know, in other words, take the question, is there an ultimate God? Well, if in order to answer that question, you have to define what you mean with ultimate. And that's what I'm saying. You are then using the linear mind to define something ultimate. And whatever you define, God is more than that. God is not that. So that's why I'm saying the question, it's the serpent swallowing its own tail. The answer to the question depends on how you formulate the question, how you define what you mean with ultimate. But the linear mind can only see ultimate in a certain way. And it will always be limited. And if it's limited, how can it be ultimate? If something is ultimate, it would have to be beyond any limitations, wouldn't it? Any definitions? And wouldn't that then be constant self-transcendence? The ultimate is self-transcendence, not still stand. Because the moment you have a definition, you have something standing still, how could it be ultimate? They have this old question where they say, God is that, how is it formulated? God is that of which nothing higher could be thought, could be conceived. And that's the linear mind saying, there has to be an ultimate definition of God that never changes. But what I have experienced is this river of life, constant self-transcendence, ongoing self-transcendence. How could it ever end? How could it ever be ultimate? How could you ever define it? It's like a river, you know. What is characteristic about a river? It's flowing. The moment it stops flowing, you don't have a river anymore, you have a pond. And the water will go bad. So, if you take a snapshot of a river and say, this is the river, you've lost the river. You've lost the most important aspect of the river, flow. I don't know what else to say. I mean, as I said, it's not a matter of understanding. It's a matter of experience. But I have experienced in myself that I can come to understand the limitations of the linear mind and understand why I can't understand something. And that has helped me. So I'm hoping this can help others. I just wanted to add a couple of thoughts to this answer, because you can, of course, say we have the level of evolving worlds of form. We have the level of the allness, where there are still beings, presences that have some characteristics. So you could say that beyond all of this, there could be a certain underlying consciousness. It's almost like you say you have a book where you have text that is written that has meaning, but beyond the text is the white paper. So you could say that there could be a ground of being, a certain level of consciousness that's simply the backdrop for everything that has form. And you could say that's the ultimate God, but then you can't say what is it like, because you can't take any characteristics and project on it. It has no characteristics whatsoever. It may be aware, there may be an awareness, but it's not something we can conceptualize and put words on. The way I deal with the whole question here is to realize that I'm right now in embodiment on a pretty dense planet called Earth. And I have the option, the potential to ascend. And my goal is to ascend, so I don't have to come back into embodiment on Earth. I become an ascended master. And then when I reach that level of consciousness, I will know, I'll be able to know things and experience things that I can't know right now. So therefore, I'm actually content to push the resolution of that question till at least after my ascension. But I could also see that we also have the potential, again, as I explained in my video about how the world was created, to grow to the greater consciousness. So maybe we won't resolve the question of is there an ultimate God until we reach the greater consciousness. Maybe it just isn't possible. I certainly don't think it's possible to resolve it for us here on Earth. I just don't think it's possible. I don't think the question can be resolved while we are on Earth. We need to rise to a higher level of consciousness, either the ascended level or the greater consciousness, before we can resolve something like this. And I'm perfectly content with that. I actually would say that reaching this realization helped me free myself from the linear mind.